Welcome to our liturgy celebration for the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. This weekend, Pope Francis has established throughout the Church the celebration of the World Day for Grandparents and Elderly on the fourth Sunday of July near the liturgical memorial of Saints Joachim and Anne, the grandparents of Jesus. In today's gospel, we are reminded to knock and keep knocking. Trust God's goodness and don't give up. Jesus says to us what he said to his disciples: ask and you will receive, seek and you will find, knock and the door will be opened to you. In this way, he is urging us to have recourse to God with confidence and persistence in all our needs. Our celebrant today is Father Daniel. Before we begin our Mass, please take a moment to silence your cell phones or any other electronic devices you have with you today. Please stand and greet the presence of Christ in those around you. Please join in singing our gathering song, Sing to the Mountains.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Christ of mercy, Lord.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that, with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In those days, the Lord said, "The outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah is so great, and their sin so grave, that I must go down and see whether or not their actions fully correspond to the cry against them that comes to me. I mean to find out." While Abraham's visitors walked on farther toward Sodom, the Lord remained standing before Abraham. Then Abraham drew nearer and said, "Will you sweep away the innocent with the guilty? Suppose there were 50 innocent people in the city. Would you wipe out the place rather than spare it for the sake of the 50 innocent people within it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to make the innocent die with the guilty, so that the innocent and the guilty would be treated alike. Should not the judge of all the world act with justice?" The Lord replied, "If I find 50 innocent people in the city of Sodom, I will spare the whole place for their sake." Adam spoke up again. "See how I am presuming to speak to my Lord, though I am but dust and ashes. What if there were 5 less than 50 innocent people? Will you destroy the whole city because of those 5? He answered, "I will not destroy it if I find 45 there." But Abraham persisted, saying, "What if only 40 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it for the sake of the 40. Then Abraham said, "Let my Lord not grow impatient if I go on. What if only 30 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it if I can find but 30 there." Still, Abraham went on. "Since I have thus dared to speak to my Lord, what if there are no more than 20? The Lord answered, "I will not destroy it for the sake of the 20. But he still persisted. "Please, let not my Lord grow angry if I speak up this last time. What if there are at least 10 there?" He replied, "For the sake of those 10, I will not destroy it." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord,
give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart. For you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple and give thanks to your name. Because of your kindness and your truth, for you have made great above all things your name and your promise. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. Exalted, yet the lowly he sees, and the proud he knows from afar. Though I walk amid distress, you preserve me. Against the anger of my enemies, you raise your hand.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, you were buried with him in baptism, in which you were also raised with him through faith in the power of God, who raised him from the dead. And even when you were dead in transgressions and the uncircumcision of your flesh, he brought you to life along with him, having forgiven us all our transgressions, obliterating the bond against us with its legal claims, which was opposed to us. He also removed it from our midst, nailing it to the cross. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus was praying in a certain place, and when he had finished, one of his disciples said to him, "Lord, teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples." He said to them, "When you pray, say, 'Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we ourselves forgive everyone in debt to us. And do not subject us to the final test.'" And he said to them, "Suppose one of you has a friend to whom he goes at midnight and says, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived at my house from a journey, and I have nothing to offer him.' And he says in reply from within, 'Do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children and I are already in bed. I cannot get up to give you anything.' I tell you, if he does not get up to give the visitor the loaves because of their friendship, he will get up to give him whatever he needs because of his persistence. And I tell you, ask and you will receive. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and the one who seeks finds. And to the one who knocks, the door will be opened. What father among you would hand his son a snake when he asks for a fish? Or hand him a scorpion when he asks for an egg? If you then, who are wicked, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" The Gospel of the Lord. In his book, The God Delusion, new atheist Richard Dawkins details the Great Prayer Experiment. This experiment featured 3 groups of sick people. One group received prayers and was informed of these prayers. Another group received prayers and was not informed of these prayers. And the third group did not receive any prayers. According to Dawkins, the results showed that no group had a better recovery rate, thus proving that prayer is ineffective. Of course, there are a lot of logical fallacies in this so-called experiment. How exactly do you measure the results of prayer? If someone experiences spiritual healing but doesn't experience physical healing, does that count as a prayer answered or unanswered? Why does this experiment presume that God always answers our prayers in the way we'd like them answered? How does this experiment filter out the prayers of people not involved in the study? What if somebody does experience physical healing, but it doesn't occur during the limited time of the experiment? Clearly, the new atheists have a very caricatured and a very misunderstood conception of prayer. Prayer doesn't change our Lord. He is beyond space and time, and therefore does not change. Rather, prayer changes us. Since God gives dignity to human participation, he calls us to persevere in prayer, not because prayer changes him, but because prayer changes us to become more like our Lord. It might seem like Abraham bargains with the Lord in today's first reading. He intercedes for the people of Sodom and Gomorrah, asking if the just God would really destroy the innocent with the wicked. Yet Abraham's prayer does not change the Lord. God already knows that he will enact justice by punishing the wicked and sparing the innocent. Rather, the Lord shares with Abraham his intentions in order to give dignity to his participation. By praying for a group of people whom Abraham doesn't even know, Abraham grows in compassion for others. This is especially significant when considering Abraham's call to serve as the Father, as to serve as the light to all nations. Yes, Abraham will receive blessings from God since he chose him to be the father of many nations. But these blessings aren't meant exclusively for Abraham and his family. They are meant to bring all people to come and to know the Lord. Thus, prayer doesn't change God. God is already perfect and doesn't need to change. Instead, prayer changes Abraham so that he can become more like the Lord. The same applies to us. Whenever we turn to God and truly offer our whole selves to him, we experience the transforming power of prayer. In today's gospel, Jesus urges us to persevere in prayer, saying, "Ask and you will receive. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you." This doesn't mean that the Lord will give us everything that we want. After all, in today's parable, the man doesn't ask for anything extravagant. He asks for bread, something that he simply needs. Since we do not worship a genie god, our Lord might say no to our prayers if we ask for something that we truly do not need. Now, we might think that if prayer doesn't change God, then why bother praying at all? Yet Christ urges us to pray because the more we pray, the more we are conformed to the Lord's will. Indeed, when we are conformed to him, then we have the confidence that we will receive what we ask for because we want what God wants for us. So by all means, take everything into prayer, even the little things of life. When we want our favorite sports team to win, we can offer up a prayer, ending with, "Let thy will be done." If we get what we want, then we offer our joy to the greater glory of God. And if we don't get what we want, then we can offer up our disappointment as well. When we want to succeed in a project, we can be honest and ask the Lord for help, ending with, "Let thy will be done." If we get what we want, then we can offer our joy to the greater glory of God. And if we don't get what we want, then we can offer up our disappointment as well. Doing so keeps our prayers rooted in the Lord's will, thus changing us to become more like him. And yet, it's still difficult to surrender to God's will, especially when we face the realities of sickness and death. We can have our faith shaken. As we continue to pray, we can feel like the man in the parable whose request for bread is constantly denied. When the Lord's will is especially difficult to accept, we can always turn to the Our Father. In our English translation, we say, "Give us this day our daily bread." But a more literal translation of the original Greek text actually reads daily bread as super substantial bread. This isn't just the bread that we need for our earthly lives, but for the bread for the whole person, body and soul. Truly, the Mass is the answer to all of our prayers. Every day we come to Mass, we receive the super substantial bread of the Eucharist, the body and blood, soul and divinity of Jesus Christ himself. So even when all hope seems lost, even when we face certain death, whenever we receive Jesus in Holy Communion, he gives us the grace that we need to hope in something greater than this life. The Eucharist truly transforms us to become more like Christ himself. May we persevere in prayer, persevere in coming to Mass regularly, so that we can allow Jesus to transform us. Even as we continue to face life's challenges, with Christ living in us, we already get a taste of heaven on earth. I believe in one God, Father the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. We pray for one another's needs in Jesus' name, knowing that whoever asks will receive, whoever seeks will find.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Church, which everywhere today celebrates the World Day dedicated to them, to be more and more welcoming home for grandparents and the elderly. For Pope Francis, that the Lord will bless and protect his ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations at war will lay down arms of destruction and move toward reconciliation and forgiveness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whose prayer lives have become dull, we'll see in Abraham's persistence with God a spark to begin prayer anew. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the all-protecting God will be the protection of all who defend us, especially police officers, firefighters, and first responders. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we have an increase of vocations, especially in our archdiocese, for men and women, may God inspire them to follow his call, and may he give them the gift of understanding to discern their service in the church, in the priesthood, in the diaconate, or consecrated life, especially our seminarians, Deacon Enrique Paseno and Tommy Green. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick, suffering, and the dying may find hope and healing in company with Christ the Redeemer, especially Deacon Steve Marsh, may be comforted through the goodness and kindness of those who minister to them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Father will raise to new life of the risen Jesus the souls of all who have died, especially our grandparents and elderly members of our families who are no longer with us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For the special intention of this Mass, Caterina Napoli, rest in peace. Also for those intentions in our book of prayer for the dying, and any other intentions we remember in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our Father, hallowed is your name. Teach us to go on confidently asking, to go on joyfully seeking, and to go on hopefully knocking at the door, so that the good things you want to give us may be ours. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Will you please join us in singing Fly Like a Bird?
To
pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his Paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Amen.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you. Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Will you please join us in singing, We Remember?
Still we celebrate for you with us here.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with a love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for some announcements. Bereavement series for this Monday, July 25th, has been canceled and will resume on Monday, August 1st at 7 p.m. in the Anita Doyle Building. Next Sunday, July 31st at 6:30 p.m., our Life Teen Ministry will be holding an evening of benediction and adoration after the 5 p.m. Mass. Please join us for the Ukrainian War Prayer Night for Peace and an effort to end this conflict. Monday, August 1st, the Virtuous Certification for Adults is being offered online via Zoom at 7 p.m. This course is for first-time certification, as well as for anyone whose certification has lapsed. Please call the Religious Education Office for registration or requests you may have. St. Dorothy's Missionary Cooperative Appeal Weekend will be August 6th through 7th. Sister Mary Ellen Howard of the Sisters of Notre Dame de Namur will be speaking at all the masses on behalf of their mission work throughout the world, making known God's goodness. As many of you are aware, our Perpetual Adoration Chapel isn't exactly perpetual at this time. We open and close in the mornings and nights, but we're looking to have it back 24/7. But we still need some time slots for people to volunteer to serve at some time slots. So if you're interested, please go to the vestibule of the church. Bernie will be there, and if you feel called, please consider signing up for the last few remaining time slots that we need in order to open up the chapel 24/7 again. As also I'm sure you've heard, there are potential talks about the mask mandate for indoors being possibly required by next weekend. If it is, we ask that, if it does pass, we ask you to please be prepared to come in with Mass for next week's Mass if you come to the indoor Masses. Thank you for your cooperation. Also, today is the World Day for Grandparents and the Elderly. Pope Francis has established that throughout the Church, the celebration of the World Day for Grandparents and Elderly on the fourth Sunday of July near the memorial of Saints Joaquin and Anne, the grandparents of Jesus. And so at this time, I would like to invite all the grandparents to stand, please, for a special blessing. God of mercy, you have given your children the gift of fruitful life, and they ask for your blessing. Let them feel the tenderness and strength of your presence. As they look back to the past, let them rejoice in your mercy. As they look to the future, may they persevere in hope that does not fade. To you be praise and glory forever. Amen. Let's give them all a round of applause. Please stand for the prayer for peace. Loving God, we pray for the people of Ukraine and for all those suffering or afraid, that you will be close to them and protect them. We pray for world leaders, for compassion, strength, and wisdom to guide their choices. We pray for the world, that in this moment of crisis, we may reach out in solidarity to our brothers and sisters in need. May we walk in your ways, so that peace and justice become a reality for the people of Ukraine and for the world. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Please join us in singing, O Bless the Lord.